Good morning, church. So glad to see each and every one of you here today. And I'd like to welcome you as well as welcome all of the folks who are watching us today on the video. So hi, hope you're doing well. Before we begin our time of worship, I think we have a few announcements that we would like to give. And I know one of them is that we are going to be having a congregational meeting on the 1st of December prior to our central board meeting. And so that will be at 7 o'clock. We would invite all members of the congregation to come, as it's an important vote to be taken, and only members can vote for that motion that will be before us. And it's one that we've discussed before. And then as soon as that is finished, we will move into our central board meeting. Our other announcements today are, I know that there's a sign-up sheet at the back for decorating the church for Christmas. Dave and Kathy have agreed to put up the tree today, and there's another assorted number of tasks to be done so that hopefully we can have the church nicely decorated for next week, which is Advent, the first of Advent. And there is also an official board meeting at 7 p.m. on Wesley, so if you at Wesley, on the 25th, which is this coming Wednesday, I believe. If you are a part of the official board, please come to that meeting, as it's an important one where budgets get set, etc. And Christmas Eve services. I know it sounds crazy, but maybe when you came up today it was snowing, so maybe it's easier to think of Christmas today. We have agreed to do two services this year because of the COVID-19 restrictions at Wesley and the number of people that we can get in the building safely. And so I would like for you to decide which one of those you would like to come to. They're both at 7 p.m. One is Wednesday, December 23rd, and one is Thursday, December 24th. Please give Barb Fearman a phone call and let her know which one you would like to go to, because as soon as they're full, we'll have to cancel the number of people coming. And on the 27th, which is the Sunday after Christmas, there will be no services at Wesley or Garnet, but I will be doing a brief message, which you can log on to and watch that morning if you so choose. And as we know, we have had to bid a fond adieu to Beth Harris for all of the work that she had done over the years of music. And so this beautiful basket has been put together by members of our congregation with contributions from all. And so thank you for that, and thank you to Beth. Are there any other announcements today? Hearing none, let us begin our time of worship. The Lord is first and last, our beginning and our end. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord our God, who was and is to come. Blessing and honor, glory and majesty be to our God, now and evermore. God, shine your light on us this morning as we gather to worship. Would you bow your heads in prayer? Just one more. Yeah, it's okay. God of justice and peace, bring your dazzling light into our hearts and spirits that we might see the glorious opportunities that we have to serve you. Help us to see that following your mandate to feed the hungry, bring nourishment to those who thirst, offer clothing to those in need, visit the sick and those who are imprisoned, welcome a stranger, any activity of service as an act is great privilege and joy. We praise you for the light of your Son, Jesus Christ, who boldly bids us to care for each other and become those who bring the good news of peace for all. Amen. And now let's listen to How Great is Our God.
Oh,
Our prayer of confession, God most holy, you're known to us as the Almighty, powerful, eternal, ruler, and Lord. We call you our shepherd and our guide. We praise you with many, many names. But you're beyond our imagination, so much greater than our words. We know you in the stories of Jesus, and in him we see your love in action, reaching out to the world. You move in us and through us by your Spirit, drawing us to you, sending us to live out your love. God most holy, three in one and one in three, we praise you with our lips and with our lives to honor you with love. Mighty and merciful God, we come with a sincere desire to walk in your ways and live under your reign. Hear us as we confess to you our sins. We confess that we have failed to love fully, forgive wholly, and to share the joy of your presence day by day. You offer us freedom, but we settle for the familiar. You offer risky love, but we opt for safe choices. You offer us hope, but we prefer to know what is happening next. Teach us to abandon our selfish ways and our cautious service so that we can risk offering you our whole lives, committed to following Jesus and building your kingdom here on earth. Amen. My friends, hear the good news. God's compassion never fades. God's grace is new every single day. God's loving kindness is steadfast. Know that we are forgiven by the grace of Jesus Christ. Forgive each other and live in peace and in harmony. Our prayer of illumination, would you bow your heads? God of mystery and majesty, your thoughts are not our thoughts and your ways are not our ways. So guide us by your Holy Spirit as we listen for your word, speaking in the scriptures, that we may encounter your living word and find our thoughts and ways transformed by your love. Amen. Our reading this morning is taken from the Gospel of Matthew, and I'm reading chapter 25, verses 31 through 40. When the Son of Man comes in his glory and all the angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate people one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. And he will put the sheep at his right hand and the goats at his left. Then the king will say to those on his right hand, come, you that are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger and you welcomed me. I was naked and you gave me clothing. I was sick and you took care of me. I was in prison and you visited me. Then the righteous will answer him, Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry and gave you food, or thirsty and gave you something to drink? And when was it that you saw a stranger and welcomed you, or naked and gave you clothing? And when was it that we saw you sick or saw you in prison? And the king will answer them, truly I tell you, just as you did it to the least of these who are members of my family, you did it to me. The inspired word of God for the inspired people of God. Thanks be to God. Friends, as we know, Jesus was a master storyteller, using stories to instruct his disciples. So this morning, rather than preach, in the manner of Jesus' way of teaching, I'm simply gonna tell you a story. Once upon a time, a woman was wandering through the marketplace, dodging barefooted children as she buys her fresh vegetables for the day. Waiting back at home are two empty jugs, waiting to be carried down to the well to fill with water. She needs those filled before she can bake her bread and do the rest of her household tasks for the day. Suddenly, there was an excitement level in the marketplace. And she could hear people yelling, "Jesus! Jesus! Jesus is here!" Now, she heard so much about this Jesus, the Savior, who would heal the blind and the lame. So she pushed closer and closer, hoping to get a little glimpse of him. The crowds parted, and there he was, so kind, with eyes so gentle. If only she could get closer to him. As she moved through the crowds, he turned, and his eyes met hers, and the world seemed to stop for a moment. And he moved through the crowds towards her. "I knew I'd find you here today. I'm coming to your house for supper." He spoke softly and smiled as he turned back to the masses. "What? Jesus is coming to my house for supper?" Instantly, her mind began to race. There was so much to do, so much that needed to be prepared to host the King of Kings. Laundry and dishes, cleaning and baking, a feast must be served for Jesus. Jesus at her home? So she rushed home and began her task of drawing the water from the well down the path. Now, the jugs were really, really heavy, and sweat trickled down her face as she hauled them on her shoulders back to her home up the rocky path. She had just finished her trek to bring the second large jar of water and was almost at her front door when a man stopped her. He was filthy and seemed weary. "Please, miss," he said, "may I have the water you've drawn to clean myself? I'm so hot and dirty from my long journey." Seriously? Didn't this man know how much work it was to draw the water and carry it all the way up the hill? Didn't this man know that she had to get ready for Jesus? "No," she barked, "I have no extra water available." And she hurried off up the path to her home, where she needed to bake her bread and set it in the sun to rise. Meanwhile, she used the rest of the water to scrub her home from top to bottom, because Jesus was coming. Everything had to be perfect. She saw a hunched over old woman hobbling up the path ahead of her. She seemed to be struggling to find her way home, while someone else would just have to help her because she had no time to spare. She brushed right past her and ignored the shaky voice saying, "Miss, can you help me find my way?" Hours later, she sat back on her knees and surveyed the scene around her. Her home sparkled from top to bottom. Time to bake the bread and to start to prepare supper. Hopefully, she'd have time to bathe before Jesus came. The smell of her bread baking began tickling her nose as she carefully set the table with her finest linens. She was imagining the things that she and Jesus would talk about when there was a knock on the door. And then she heard a knock on the door, and she rushed, but met a small boy with pleading eyes. "Please, miss, might I have some of that delicious bread that I can smell baking? I'm so very hungry." "No," she snapped, "I have no extra. I'm having a very important guest tonight." And with that, she slammed the door. "Don't people know how busy I am?" she said aloud. Moments later, as she brushed her long hair and washed her face, she heard a crying baby and a frantic knock at the door. And there stood a flustered mother with a baby on her hip, saying, "Please, miss, can I borrow a few cups of milk? My baby's hungry and I have none." "I don't have time to milk the cow," she said. "Be off with you. Go and beg somewhere else." And she shut the door firmly in the face of the young mother. With quick hands, she prepared the most lovely meal, fit for a king, complete with warm, fresh bread and a clean house. She smoothed her hair back from her face as she surveyed the scene around her. Despite all of her interruptions, she had completed all of her tasks. Jesus would be arriving any moment. She could not wait. An hour passed. Oh, Jesus must have got hung up on
the way to her house, she thought. And then another hour passed, and she walked out the front door to see if maybe he was lost, but there was nobody in sight. She headed back inside to recheck the food and to relight the lanterns. She would be sure that Jesus would see her house. Another half hour passed, and no Jesus. She was so very tired from her day's hard work. Perhaps she'd just rest her eyes for a moment. The next morning, she woke up. She'd fallen asleep in the chair. There was burnt out candles, cold food, and an empty heart. Why hadn't Jesus come, like he said? Angry, she set out for the marketplace to find him. And with purposeful strides, she stopped to the area of where peddlers were selling their wares. And in one sweeping glance, she spotted him. And she marched right up to him and said, "Jesus, you were to come to dinner last night. I was ready for you. I prepared a feast fit for a king. Why didn't you come?" "Oh, my child," he said tenderly, "I did come, and you turned me away." And her mouth dropped open. No words. And so Jesus continued. "First, I was a weary traveler seeking refreshment, but you gave me none. Then I was an old woman, needing your guiding hand, but you brushed me aside." A single tear formed in her eye and slipped silently down her cheek. "Next, I was a hungry boy, but you had no bread for me." Her head drops in shame. Tears hit the sand at her feet, and Jesus continues. "And lastly, I was a frantic mother with a crying baby, but you offered me nothing. You shut the door in my face. You had no room for me in your home or your busy schedule." Jesus placed his loving arm around her shaking shoulders and spoke softly in her ear. "Remember, my beloved, for as much as you do for the least of these, you do for me. And remember, I love you." And with that, he left, continuing on his journey to the next village. But he never left her heart, for she would never forget that moment, the day that Jesus came to her door many, many times, and yet she turned him away. How many times have we missed Jesus? In our rush to get to our next appointment, our next errand, or home to make dinner, have we missed him? That woman who dropped her groceries as her bag ripped right in front of you, could she be Jesus? Yet you sidestepped her as you continued to walk to your car. How about the time that you were prompted to give a homeless man rummaging through the garbage some money, but you talked yourself out of it? After all, they only use it for drugs, right? Jesus. What about that checkout person in Walmart who was too greasy and pierced for your taste, so you rushed through their line with nary a smile or a good morning, tapping your nails impatiently as they fumbled for your change? Jesus. Don't miss him. You only rob yourself of blessings here and in the here and the after. Our job is to be like Jesus around us. Everything we say or do should be filtered through him and a reflection of him. Keep your eyes open, your hearts soft, and be aware of those around you, for you never know when you might be asked to have Jesus come to dinner. When I needed a name. bow your heads and pray with me. Lord Jesus, you proclaim God's kingdom among us and within us. In the power of the Spirit, your love is always at work, bringing good out of evil and life out of death. We thank you that your love never lets us go, for you have known the good times and the hard times of this life before us. You came as one who was hungry and thirsty, where people live on the streets today, suffer from hunger or beg for a meal. Your kingdom come, your will be done. You came as a stranger in need of welcome, where people live lonely lives or feel like strangers in a strange land, where love is lacking and people face rejection for the color of their skin or the language that they speak. Your kingdom come, your will be done. You came as one who was naked, where people lack enough clothing or shelter or life's basic resources, where people live without dignity, exposed to every kind of pain and hardship. Your kingdom come, your will be done. You came as one who was broken, where people feel pain in body, mind, or spirit, where someone grieves the loss of a beloved or the future they planned, in places where the pandemic has done its worst and desperation has moved in. Your kingdom come, your will be done. You came as a shepherd, where people are led astray or nations are ruled by corrupt or greedy leaders, where there's no peace in the land. Your kingdom come, your will be done. You came as one who was in prison, where people are treated unfairly, targeted, or tortured, where justice has failed and people are punished with cruelty. Your kingdom come, your will be done. You came as one proclaiming the kingdom of God, and so we lift up these prayers in your name, Jesus, knowing that your kingdom is drawing near, and that we may meet you in the face of those who cry out to us. Hasten the day when God will wipe away our tears and death will be no more as we pray the words that you taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. My friends, God has blessed us in Christ and in creation with all that we need to thrive. Yet Jesus' story reminds us that there are so many in this world who do not have what they need. What we offer today helps the church reach out to the men, touch many lives in need, and share the love of God in so many ways. So let us use our gift of imagination as we reflect on the offerings that we dropped in the offering plate as we entered the sanctuary this morning. And now we ask a blessing to be upon those offerings, generous and gracious God. You envision a world where the hungry are fed and the prisoners are welcomed. We bring you our gifts to be part of your vision. Bless them and bless us all, so that our gifts bear fruit in Christ's name and honor him as the Lord of our lives. Amen. Go now in peace. My friends, hear the cry of those in need. Go into God's world, enabled by Christ, to be in ministries of compassion for all of God's people. Love this world as God has loved you. Care tenderly always for all of creation. Go and faithfully serve in the name of Jesus.